We all know the story of the XYZ Anime Pokemon League. Ash does phenomenally, beating everyone in the competition, and even making it to the finals, just to get robbed from becoming champion thanks to Alan and his Mega Charizard. But is that really the case? Was Ash just a bad trainer that deserved to lose, or was he robbed from his chances of becoming champion? Well, that's something we're trying to find out as we attempt a Pokemon Y Hardcore Nuzlocke using only Ash's anime team. With this information, we know we are only left with a total of 6 Pokemon. A lot of my Pokemon are really strong, but already I see a huge problem with the team. Be sure to comment down if you see it. For those who don't know what a Hardcore Nuzlocke is, the rules are pretty simple. But in short, if a Pokemon faints, it's dead, and I can't use it anymore. I can only catch my first encounter in each route or town, no items in battles but held items are allowed, I must play the games and set rules, no exceptions, and I can't be higher than a gym leader's or Elite Force Ace. Before starting, I would really appreciate it if you guys subscribe since it greatly helps me out. And if you guys can like this video, that would be nice also. With all that being said, let's get right into this Nuzlocke. After being woken up in the rudest way possible, I head to Aquacore Town to get our first Pokemon. Froakie, which I named Harry. Trust me, you'll get the reference, just stay tuned. Yeah, call me Big A, because I have a big ego. We get our Pokeballs and we catch our first encounter, a fledgling in Route 2. I'll name you Gwen. Hopefully you don't die this time, because you'll be extremely helpful for this run. In the Tantaloon Forest, we encounter the mascot of the series, Pikachu. Your name's gonna be Peter. Seriously? A brave nature? You're not supposed to be slow, man. Hopefully you have the same amount of plot armor you have in the anime, because Jesus, that's overpowered. After EB training my Pokemon a bit, I felt like I had the power to beat the first gym. With Peter by my side, this should be a piece of cake. She leads with Surfskit. And with the power of God and anime by my side, I was able to sweep her entire team by just using Thundershock, winning us a battle and getting us a bug badge. Peter is so amazing, no wonder you called spectacular. The road to the second gym is extremely long, so I'll just mention the important bits. Oh, a cool Pokemon? Let me see.
Who's gonna tell him?
On our way to High Lake City, Harry evolves into Frogadier, and Gwen evolves into Fletchinder. After getting a team for Thief, I head back into the Suntulan Forest to annihilate the entirety of the Pikachu population. But trust me, there's a good reason for this. If I use Thief on the Pikachu, I have a 5% chance to get a Light Ball, which is an item that literally doubles Pikachu's special attack and attack. Trust me, this is gonna be really handy for the challenges we'll need to face. I'm not a monster, I swear. No Pikachus were harmed during the making of this video. We soon make it to the Perfume Palace, and here we have a date with Shauna. I don't think a few people would appreciate that.
Who the fuck is this?
In the Glittering Cave, we have an option to choose one of two fossils. Here, I want you guys to predict what fossil I'll choose. I'll give you guys 5 seconds. If you guys guess a sail fossil, congrats! Here's an omelet, it's good for you.
You can also borrow Pikachu's ketchup, just don't tell him. He'll get angry.
Anyways, I finally made it to Psylake City, and with the team I have right now, I don't think I can beat the gym. Luckily for us, in Route 10, we encounter a new Pokemon that will definitely help us out. Hawlucha. I'll name you MJ. She's extremely overpowered because not only does she have insane attack and speed, but she also has Encore. I'll be abusing that, thank you very much. If only she didn't have a relaxed nature, but whatever. I head over to Grant, and the battle goes as expected. He leads with Amora as he leads with MJ. Predicting him to use Thunder Wave, I use Encore. After getting plus 4, I was able to sweep his entire team with just Rock Smash, winning us a battle and getting us a Cliff Badge.
Easy clap!
You know what? Team player are absolute jokes. Hopefully karma doesn't bite me in the ass for saying that. In Jiaxin's Town, we have a battle with Karina, which we absolutely dominated. Hopefully this is foreshadowing for our actual gym battle. Ma'am, please keep your dog away from me. I made it to Shalor City and here, I got the team for Dig, which would be really helpful. And I also got the Eviolite, which is an item that increases both defense and special defense if a Pokemon isn't fully evolved. My Pokemon aren't gonna be fully evolved anytime soon, so mine, this is mine. In the Tower of Mastery, we have a battle with Serena to determine who's gonna own the rights of Mega Evolutions. But honestly, I don't think I could even call this a battle. This was so one-sided that it was so bad. All I needed to do was trick her Meowsec into using Fake Out, and the rest was history. As for Karina's gym, yeah, they weren't any better also. The gym trainers were bled thanks to MJ, and Karina, how should I say this?
She sucked.
As I lead with MJ, she sent to her Mianfu. She used Fake Out.
Oh yeah, it's all coming together.
And of course, I use Encore, and I use Swords Dance to get plus 6. I am now unstoppable. and after a series of aerial aces, I was able to sweep her entire team, winning us a battle and getting us the Rumble Badge. Thankfully, I was able to outspeed her Hawlucha despite my nature, because Jesus, this could have gone so badly if I didn't. After beating Karina, we were finally able to get the Mega Ring, which we can't even use because no one on my team can Mega Evolve. So that's great. She did offer me a dog though. Fine, I'll rescue the puppy. I don't want it staying with a horrible trainer after all. To the box you go. Because I was so close to surpassing the level cap, I rode on a Skittle to avoid some trainers. I don't know if that really mattered, but I still rode some Skittles. In the same route, I found some leftovers. This is an item that gradually heals up a Pokemon HP over time. This might be helpful for the future, so I'll take it. I soon make it to Chimerian City, and here I got the TM for Acrobatics, which deals damage like any other move, but this certain move literally doubles in power if the Pokemon does not have an item. And trust me, this is gonna be my lord and savior for this run. Also here, we have yet another rubber battle with Serena, which pretty much goes the same way because of Encore. Look, I'm not noticing you, okay? Leave me alone! With that, I head straight into the gym, and because of MJ and Gwen, the gym trainers were complete jokes. But we gotta face Ramos, so I gave the Ebelite to Gwen and head straight into battle. I lead with Gwen as he leads with Jumpluff. I know it's pretty weird letting him use agility, but in one of my attempts, Jumpluff actually outspeeds me, so I'm just being cautious right now. That ended up not mattering though, because after using acrobatics on me, I was able to burn him, which lowers his attack. This allowed me to get +6, and after setting up, I was able to sweep his entire team with just using aerial ways, winning us a battle and getting us a plant badge. And not only that, Gwen evolved into Talonflame, and I'm so excited to use this burb. She's gonna be so useful. I know a lot of the gym battles seem pretty easy because I just swept them all, but that's because I put some time into strategizing on the best way to beat them. I'm not going in guns blazing hoping for the best, that would be stupid. I want to win this Nuzlocke after all, so I want to make as little mistakes as possible. And trust me, later on in the run, this Nuzlocke does get a lot harder. We're now on our way to Lemon City, which is where our boy Clement's gonna be. And boy, this gym's gonna be so hard. Before that, I use Steve on the Lapras so I can steal their Mystic Water. And also, please subscribe, I need validation from internet strangers to fill the void in my soul. Anyways, thanks for watching! On the way there, we ran into Team Flare once again, and for some reason they're messing with the Kalos power plant? What do you guys have to gain from this? You guys are so complete jokes. No karma given to me yet. Soon we make it to Lumina City, and now it's time for me to explain why we got the light ball. If you look at my team, yeah, a lot of them can get wrecked if I use them against Clement. So I can really only use Peter in this battle, which is really risky considering he's, well, a Pikachu. With the Light Ball, this might give me enough power to Oko all his Pokemon. I just need to change my Eevee from this to this. And while grinding up, Harry evolved into Greninja. And ka-chow, we should now be ready. The Dr. Octopus wannabe sends out Imoka, as I of course send out Peter. Thanks to my light bulb, one Thunderbolt was able to knock out the Pikachu ripoff. Next is his ace, Heliolisk. Thanks to the dig I obtained earlier, I was easily able to Oko him. And now it's time for his last Pokemon, Magneton. I used Thunderbolt because I knew that Sturdy would prevent him from getting knocked out. He then used his Thunderbolt back at me and... Jesus! Luckily I survived to deliver a finishing blow, but fuck man, don't give me a heart attack man! Wow, this place isn't sus at all. In Route 14, we have yet another rival battle. Get the f*** out of here! And I ran into another Pokemon that I'll be adding on my team. Gumi, with a lonely nature. What is up with these horrible ass natures, man? This little guy is gonna be named J. Jonah. I'll give you Spider-Man if you lead us a victory. How about that? This is pretty sick because now we have someone to deal with electric types, which has been a huge pain in the ass for the longest time. We soon go into a random house in the middle of the swamp. What can possibly go wrong? I make it to Library City, home of the fairy type gym, and I'll be playing like Ash for a bit. And by that, I'll be putting myself at a disadvantage by using MJ. But don't worry, we got a plan. Because her Mawile doesn't have a fairy type move, I can freely set up for yet another sweep. While grinding, J. Jonah evolves into Sligo, and with that, we are ready to face Valerie. She sends out Mawile as a leak with MJ. When she used Iron Defense, I use Encore of course. And after a bit of dancing with the swords, a soft-sanded dig was able to knock her out. And after two aerial aces, I was able to knock both Ash's dad and Sylveon out, winning us a battle and getting us a fairy badge. I once again ran into Team Flare, invading a whole ass factory. Jesus, okay, I'm sorry for calling you guys absolute jokes, can you please stop causing crime now? Aw, oh, god damn it, leave Obamacillo alone. We soon meet a lady that helps us remember moves from our past life. All I need to give is my heart and soul. Or a heart skill, that works as well. I taught Harry Nightslash because the next gym is a psychic type one, and honestly, I need all the advantages I can get. I also taught him Power Up Punch and Substitute. I can't guarantee a victory, but hopefully this is enough to beat her.
Whoa, she's floating, bruh.
As she leads with Tickleff, I send in Harry. Expecting her to use Reflect and Light Screen, I use Substitute and Power Up Punch to increase my attack. Wanting to get rid of Reflect as soon as possible, I use another sub. But now I put myself in a predicament, because now, Harry can easily get taken out. And honestly, I don't want my first death. Thankfully, that really didn't matter, and a Nightslash was able to take him out. This is still really risky though. Next is her Slowking, which of course goes onto a Nightslash. And now it's time for her ace, Meowstic. All you need to do now is use Nightslash. Right? Holy crap! Nope, nope, nope. I want out. Get me out of here. Thankfully, a Nightslash was able to take her out, but come on. My poor heart can't take this, man. This is too much. As I stepped out of the gym, Lysander called us to basically call everyone outside of Team Flare ugly. Buddy, you literally look like Mufasa. Chill out there. Jokes aside, this is probably gonna be the hardest part of the Nuzlocke because of one thing and one thing only. Lysander. His Gyarados is absolutely terrifying and can easily sweep my team if I play like crap. But you guys know me, I got a plan for this. By giving Jay Joanna a rare candy in a rain, he evolves into Goodra. In Azure Bay, we have a chance to get a Heaven Berry, which is a berry that lowers the damage of super effective dragon moves. I can give this to Jay Joanna to resist the incoming outrage, and to one-shot him with Thunderbolt. With that, I can hopefully annihilate Lysander without any problem. Never mind, I guess. Because Gwen was able to hand me this win on a silver platter, goes to show that a big brain strat isn't needed to win a battle. I hope I can continue winning this way. I'll use those berries another day. As I explore their lab, they force me to choose between two buttons. One will detonate the weapon, and one won't. Knowing their massive ego, I chose the right button, which is obviously the red one, cause there's no way this isn't... We again have another battle with Mufasa himself, but of course we clapped him as usual, and all we need to do now is save the world. You know, a normal weekend for Ash. I look at Death straight in the face, and I immediately use Master Ball to capture his ass. And soon after, we are forced to once again face Lysander. But this time, I'm kinda worried, because his Mega Gyarados can actually prevent me from sweeping. I'll need to fully set up with Sword Sense, and thankfully, I was easily able to burn him to pull it off. After getting plus 6, I was able to knock out his entire team with just Acrobatics. Thankfully, I was able to play around this scary battle, because we could've easily lost someone during this. Ash is actually cracked in this region. As we explore Terminus Cave, we get our final encounter. Noibat, with a sassy nature. And to the very end, I end up with very horrible natures. Whatever. I'll name you Aunt May, because she was so badass in Into the Spider-Verse, and Noivern's gonna be a huge addition to the team. In Route 19, we have a battle back to back to back with our rivals. But yeah, they're pretty weak, so it's not even worth mentioning. No wonder you left Team Flare to me, y'all suck! With a bit of preparation, I'm ready to face a final gym leader, Wolfric. I led with Gwen since it's the best option for me, and Flamethrower was able to knock out his Abomasnow. As he sends out Coragonal, I used Flamethrower. Sadly, it wasn't enough, but Harry took care of it with a power-up punch. As for his ace, Avalok was easily taken out with a few serves, winning us a battle and getting us a final gym badge. All we need to do now is survive the victory road so we can finally face the Elite Four. And with the team I have right now, I believe that I'll be able to handle it without any problems. Of course, in here, we have a lot of close calls, and we even have one final battle with Serena. This should be easy. After all I need to do is protect an Encore and... Oh sh! I did not expect that. There's a way around this, but now I can't sweep her team like I usually do. I sent in Harry and a few Nightslashes was able to knock him out. Next is Altaria. I sent in Jay Jonah, and after an Ice Beam, it goes on without any problems. Her Vaporeon was taken out with a few Thunderbolts, but now I'm really low, so it's all up to Gwen to take care of the Chestnut. Because of the paralysis, I ended up being slower than Absol, and her Nightslash actually crit me, leaving me at 3 HP. Holy fuck! Serena, this is why Ash doesn't fucking love you! After a bit of a heart attack, I made it to the Pokemon League. I am so hyped, and I'm feeling so confident. My team is so powerful that I feel like Ash really did get robbed. All I need to do is grind up, and I should be good. No! Did we really lose our mascot right before the Elite Four? No fucking way, dude. And with that, that was the first death of our Nuzlocke. That's what I get for being too overconfident. I gotta be more cautious when I grind up. He's been there for the longest time, so... This sucks so much. Rest in peace, Peter. You deserve so much better for everything you've done for the team. And with that, we only have 5 Pokemon to face the Elite Four, and even a champion. So, here they are. and somehow are gonna make a champion out of all of them. But enough of that, let's battle the Elite Four. I decided to face the easiest Elite Four member, Wickstrom, the Steel-type Elite Four member. I chose to lead with Aunt May as he sends out his car keys. Expecting him to torment, I used Boomburst so I can do some chip damage, and after a flamethrower, I was able to melt him into oblivion. He then sends out Probopass, which I prepared for in the form of J. Jonah. Since he can't do too much damage to me, I mean, come on, my boy is thick. I just spam flamethrower to take him out. He then sends out Aegislash.
Perfect.
I switch into Gwen and use Will-O-Wisp to lower his attack. And all I need to do now is stall him out because now he's just a fish out of water. I use Sword Sand to make me unstoppable. And after activating my Shishis Berry, I use Acrobatics to not only knock him, but also Scizor out. Winning us a battle and making this the first member? Down. Next is a Dragon-type Elite Four member, Drasna. I had a plan where I would give MJ a Wakan Berry, so that I could use Sword Sense without any problems and just sweep. But yeah, that didn't happen. I now have to beat her in an unorthodox way. I switch into Aunt May to take care of it, but that ended up being useless because he ended up surviving somehow. And now, Aunt May can actually die from poison if she stays in, so she's gotta go. Luckily, J. Jonah took care of it. Next is Altaria, and a single Ice Beam absolutely destroys this stupid bird. She then sends out her Noivern, but again, it was no match for J. Jonah. Another Ice Beam takes it out. She then sends out her last Pokemon, Drudagon. Knowing he probably won't be surviving a Dragon Tail, I switch into Gwen. And this immediately turned into a switching fest where almost all my Pokemon got sent into the field. Thank God Aunt May didn't though, because she would've died and I would've been livid. After one Night Slash, she immediately goes down, winning us a battle and making this a second member? Down. This could've gone a lot worse, but thankfully, it didn't. Next is a Fire-type Elite Four member, Malba. Definitely the hottest Elite Four member.
Really? Again?
I'm sorry, please, I'm sorry! She sends out Pyroar as Ascendant Harry. Because of my Wakan Berry, the super effective Electric-type moves doesn't do too much to me, and I was able to set up a power-up punch. This was enough for me to sweep her entire team with just Waterfall. Winning us a battle and making this a third member? Down. You may be the hottest Elite Four member, but damn are you the weakest. Now, it's time for the Water-type Elite Four member. Seabold, probably one of the hardest battle in this run, but thankfully, we got a plan. I'll give J. Jonah a Habanberry so Dragon Pulse won't be doing too much to me, and I'll be using Confide to lower his special attack by -4. With that, I switch into MJ and use Encore to prevent the confusion with Water Pulse. I then use Sword Stance, and with this, I should be able to sweep. God fu- And just like that, my plan goes down the drain. I don't know what else to do, so I switch into Harry hoping for the best. I use Power Up Punch and after a Night Slash, I was able to take it out. He then sends out Barbarical. I knew a cross shop can take me out, so I decided to say goodbye to Harry. Thank you so much, Harry. You were so phenomenal. Okay? He just flinches? I guess we take those? Next is Starmie, which obviously goes down to a Night Slash. And now it's time for his last Pokemon, Gyarados. I used Rock Slide, and after a Dragon Dance, I thought this was the end for Harry. But I ended up outspeeding, and Harry knocks him out with a Rock Slide, winning us a battle and making this the last member down. I should have been punished for this, there's absolutely no way. Now, we have the champion, and I can't believe how close we are to proving how robbed my boy Ash was. I am so ready to finally put an end to this. Ash deserves so much better, so enough celebrating, we still have one more trainer to face. Diantha, the champion of the Kalos region. So let's beat her, so we can finally claim what's ours. She leads with Hawlucha, Ice Ascendant, Aunt May. Thanks to Air Slash, I was able to knock it out. Next is her Aurorus. I use Brick Break not wanting to risk a Focus Blast miss, and her Blizzard misses. Okay? Another one was able to take her out. Her Tyantrum goes down to one Dragon Pulse. Dear God, please do not make this easy. All this hype! And for this? As she sends out her Gudra, a few Dragon Pulses were easily able to knock it out, making this yet another elimination for Aunt May. She then sends out Gorgeist, which goes down to an Air Slash. Come on, it should not be this easy. Last is her ace, Mega Gardevoir. Knowing Aunt May has done enough for the team, I decided to sack her off. Thank you so much for all your help. You were phenomenal. But now, it's time for us to finish this off. I switch into Gwen, and with one Acrobatics, we knocked out her last Pokemon, and finally completed this Nuzlocke. I had so much fun doing this that I'm so fucking down to do more hardcore Nuzlockes with an anime team. So, can I beat a Pokemon Y Hardcore Nuzlocke using only Ash's Pokemon? Yes. And yes, Ash was indeed robbed. If you guys have any suggestions on what anime team or manga team I should use, please comment it down below. I would love to hear it. But other than that, thank you guys for watching me suffer, and be sure to watch me suffer more with these hardcore Nuzlocks. If not, I'll see you guys later. Bye-bye!